What's up, man? Welcome to I'll Pump You Up.com's YouTube channel. I'm your host, Tim Muriello, fitness and supplement expert. Check out who I have here. This is my girl, right? What's your name?
Kayla Jindra.
And didn't she say that so nice? Kayla Jindra. She's an up and coming bikini competitor. This girl, let me tell you, this girl, I remember when she first started competing, and it's been a couple years now, she's just gaining more and more popularity, more exposure, she's winning titles, she's doing phenomenal. And this girl is trying so hard to get her pro card. She wants to get that pro card. So what we did, yes, we made a video that's more towards women. We want to give this video, this information, to women that are looking to be a bikini competitor. Maybe you want to be a bikini competitor. Maybe you are a bikini competitor and want to do better. Well, we're gonna talk with Kayla. We're gonna really pick her brain, and she's gonna give us some really good information that we think is really gonna help you out. How did you get started as a bikini competitor? Did it just dawn on you, oh, I wanna be a bikini competitor. This is what I wanna do. Or what kind of got you into all this?
Honestly, it was one of our old roommates, Maury O'Malley, and my boyfriend Derek Blewett, and they did their first bodybuilding show together. Went and I watched them both on stage, and I saw the bikini aspect of it, and I kind of got hooked. So a couple months later, I got a trainer who has taken me this far. Absolutely love her, Amy Bien, and now I'm here today.
So you looked on stage, you saw them girls, and you were like, dang, I could do that.
It looked
I could do this, I could win this. That's killer.
I wanted to transform my body. That was one of also my main goals.
Okay, and now were you, not to ask you a personal question, but were you like overweight, like really overweight,
or were you in decent shape? I was like an average girl. I was 130 at my highest weight.
Yeah, that's
not
bad.
But you know, just I didn't have muscle.
Yeah.
And I wanted to just tone and transform. So having a goal to be on stage, I would push and I would do it and I wouldn't give up.
Explain this to me with BPI. She was one of the top three contestants in a big nationwide model search by BPI Nutrition.
Yes.
What was that? How did they find you? How did that whole thing come about?
I actually applied on their website 2 weeks before I did Florida State.
Okay.
So I had to fill out a bio and put pictures, and it was actually about a week after I finished Florida State that I got an email that I made top five. Freaked out. So then about 2 weeks later, I found out I made top three, and I didn't make it to Vegas, but I was so happy and so fortunate I made it that far.
How many years have you been competing in bikini?
It's been about a full year.
And she's already top three BPI model search. I mean, that's pretty sick. So we've seen you on stage a couple times. We have another interview on our YouTube channel with you. What is it like as far as diet is concerned? Are you eating a lot of high protein, or on the contrary, are eating less protein and like a lot of really, really low carbs to try to lose as much weight as possible? What does a typical bikini competitor's diet looks like?
Well, I usually start off on a little bit of a higher carb and a higher protein diet until I get closer out into the show.
Okay.
And then I cut my carbs and cut my proteins by a little bit.
Okay.
And I actually went on a carb fat cycle my last probably 3 weeks before my show.
What is that?
It was just a carb fat cycle between higher fats and carb days.
Okay, so like
alternating
one day high carb
and
the next day low carb, and during your high carb day you eat low fat, and the low carb day you eat high fats,
yeah.
Right?
That's
hilarious. Yeah.
So I would do that, and I actually didn't deplete this time. So I just stayed on the fat cycle all the way through. My body
did it work pretty good?
Yeah, no, I came in perfect, and my body is pretty much adapted to it. I stayed on diet like 9 months last year.
Holy smokes. 9 months you dieted.
Yes, last year.
Ladies, listen, this girl's dieting nine dang months. That's insane. What about the workouts? I mean, are you just hitting all weights, or are you doing pretty much what most people think? Oh, bikini competitors, all they do is the dang cardio equipment. They're on the stepper all the time. I mean, what does your workout look like for a bikini competitor?
I mean, I have to hit the weights heavy. You have to gain muscle.
Guys, you hear that? Ladies and gentlemen, she said heavy in the gym.
Especially in your off season, that's when you grow the most.
Yeah.
I did not slack in my off season. I took about 6 months to try and grow last year, and that's when I hit it hard. The gym 5 times a week. You have to. That's where your gains are made.
Yeah.
So I hit it hard, and then when it comes down to contest prep time, I still lift, you know, heavy. I'm on the cardio. I do the stepper about 3 times a week. You need those glutes. So
yeah, that's right.
You gotta
shaping them glutes up.
But otherwise, I mean, it's not that bad. You know, you just portion your times out and
How many days a week were you doing cardio?
I was on 7 days a week.
7 days a week cardio? 2 a days at all?
Yes. But I mean, everybody's different. So, you know, my plan that I have would be completely different for somebody. So that's just a disclaimer out there.
Yeah, no, that is very true. Very true. How many weeks out did it take you to diet for your first show? Did it take 16 weeks?
I do 12. I do 12.
12 weeks?
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty good.
So it's not bad. I mean, for me personally, I cut out sugar as well because my legs are my problem area. So I'm not, you know, I'm not ashamed to say that. There's things that I have to do to get to where I need to be.
Yeah,
so
definitely.
It's a sacrifice, but you know, I'm willing to make it to come in good.
Well,
so.
I mean, let's be honest. A lot of people, they think, oh, bikini competitors, they don't work out hard. They don't diet hard. All they have to do is diet for 4 weeks. I mean, it sounds to me like there's a lot more that goes into being a bikini competitor. Dude, you're freaking hitting the weights heavy. You're doing 7 day a week cardio twice a day sometimes. You're dieting hardcore. I mean, dude, there's a lot more into it. What are they looking for, man? Because I've been a judge. I've judged many bikini competitors. And I hear different things every show I do, right? Every show I judge.
Yep.
You want something that just looks sexy on the beach. You want, you know, this, you want that. But what are they really looking for in a bikini competitor? Are they looking for just top and bottom? Are they looking for, I'm just keeping it real. You know what I'm saying? Are they looking for just muscle? What if you have a six pack? What are they really looking for?
I still have not found out, personally.
Yeah, dude.
I don't know, but I go off of my critiques, and that I can't stress enough how important it is after every show you do, get your critiques from the judges to find out what you need to improve on. And consistently, since I've, you know, done my first show up until my last show that I just did, I always get a critique, and I'm getting better and better and better. But you know, my shoulders, I still need to build my shoulders, and my glutes and my hamstrings and my quads, they need to grow. So taken from those two aspects, I just hit it hard on those two areas, and I know that's what I need to do.
Yeah, that's killer.
But you know, everybody's different. Some people are just, you know,
some chicks
really
have
good.
A naturally, they have a natural ghetto booty, you know, they just got muscle back there, you know what I'm saying? They don't need to do all that. They just get on the stepper, they're legit. So the good thing is, and the good takeaway with that is definitely talk with the judges. You know, a good judge should always take notes.
Yes.
Like me, when I judge, I always have notes of everybody, you know. A good judge will take notes. Go up to a judge, man, pick their brains, all of them. Hey, what do I need to work on? What are you looking for? Very, very important. Kayla's done that. She's used that as a plan of attack, gone to the drawing board, and has come back better and better every year. Now let's talk about stage presence. I've seen some chicks on bikini competitors with terrible, all right? Can you say that? Say terrible.
Terrible.
Terrible, all right? even Kayla said terrible stage presence, all right? And they're not even freaking smiling up there. They're not smiling, they look all pissed, like.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And it's like, dude, you gotta have some dang stage presence. What are these, talk to these ladies, man. They're not gonna listen to me. They need to listen to you. That's why I brought you on camera. They're not gonna listen to me.
It is key. And I've even had a bad experience with it last time. I can't stress how bad you just need to shine for your confidence. So you need, confidence is key, honestly.
Yeah, confidence is key.
Even if you look at those girls and you think that every one of them looks better than you, in your head, you need to be like, I'm number one, and you need to let it shine. That is my number one.
At least smile, dang it.
And smile, and you have to bring it. You have to have pep. Don't
you gotta
overdo
bring it.
But
she said you gotta bring it, ladies.
Gotta bring it.
Yeah, bring it.
You know, my last show I did, I kind of freaked out a little bit, I guess I could say.
Your last show?
Yeah, I wanted my qualifications so bad, and I feel like my nerves got the best of me.
Yeah.
And honestly, like, I got my critique after, and I was like, what can I work on? And I, pretty much all my critiques were, where were you tonight? Because my stage presence was like, compared to my last show at Europa.
Whatever's going on in your mind is gonna show in your countenance and your demeanor and your presence on stage. What about getting your name out there? Because you know, you've consistently been doing shows, but you've also picked up some little side jobs here and there, and you're getting your name out there, obviously, at BPI. How critical, and what are some other things that women can do to get their name out there, man, to get some other opportunities as a bikini competitor?
I mean, I'm still trying as well, but I always say try and network as best as you can. If there's any expo that you go to, if there's any online opportunities, like BPI was just online, you know, I search and I look. what can I enter in? What show, you know, like Europa, like what booths can you go to to see, you know, do you need demo help? Like, would you ever need this? Would you ever need that?
I like that. Yeah. And do you need demo help? Do you need me to work a gym for you?
Exactly. Because there's so many little side jobs that these supplement companies need help for.
Yeah.
And it's just not, you know, they're not going to necessarily throw it out there, but you have to go to them.
Yeah, you got to get your name out there. You got to be aggressive with it.
Yeah.
Kayla's done some work with us, man. She's done some work with Muscle Tech. She works, what company are you with now? That you're doing work for now, the coconut oil?
And I currently work for Calipo Coconut Oil, and I do their communications.
Okay.
And so that's really good. We do a lot of expos ourselves. But if you ever want to check them out, calipo.com. If you ever
How do you spell that?
K-E-L-A-P-O. If you use coconut oil in your diet, which I do, I love it.
Yeah,
so
awesome.
Yeah, feel free to check them out.
So look what she's saying, guys. Look, the girl doing bikini competitions, and then she's taking it upon herself. She's not waiting for people to knock on her door. She's knocking on their door saying, look, this is what I can offer you, and this is what I can do for you. Look, she's getting side jobs. She's getting gigs. Now she got a career position with this company. I mean, dude, she's a good role model for somebody who has taken fitness and her enjoyment and love of fitness and actually launched it out there like a net and just got some good opportunities with it. So, very cool. Well, I'll ask two questions for you, all right? And we're gonna stop beating you up with questions.
Okay.
We're gonna stop the interrogation. All right, who do you admire? Pretty simple question, but is there any one physique? I know there's a lot of pros that you probably admire. All the girls admire the top pros, but is there any one or two IFBB bikini model pros that you admire?
I really don't have a favorite per se. All of them are so inspirational.
Yeah.
Honestly, Erin Stern gives out a lot of good motivation.
Yeah, she's good.
And I just saw Michelle Lewin actually at Southeastern.
Okay.
This weekend, and she was an inspiration on stage. Looks amazing.
Yeah.
So just, you know, all I can do is look at these women and be like, oh, I want to be them one day. So
yeah,
it's inspiration, just in
awesome.
General.
And then lastly, what do you want to do? You know, we're trying to talk to people about how to be a successful bikini competitor. You need goals. You got to have goals, right?
Yeah.
What are your goals? What are some things that you're aiming for so these women can be like, dang, those are some good goals. Maybe those are some good ideas that I can do myself. What are your goals for like the next couple of years as far as getting your name out there and being a very successful bikini competitor?
I still have a lot of goals. Honestly, my number one goal right now is to try and get a sponsorship with somebody.
Sponsorship.
Okay. It definitely, everything gets expensive, and trying to do nationals next year, it's something that, you know, I need help with.
Yeah.
You know, becoming pro, that's become a goal of mine as well.
Yeah.
Probably gonna take
if you get a pro card,
a little
you're
bit
get a
longer, but
yeah. Well, the thing is, you become pro, you'll get a sponsorship.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So that, you know, just to work on my areas, I take my critiques as, you know, corrective criticism, I should say, and I'm running with it. I'm
yeah.
just trying to get better every day, and gotta work hard. Putting my work in the off season right now come back next year.
That's right. That's awesome, dude. Well, we're glad to have you. Guys, hopefully you learned some good stuff. You got some good pieces of information that you could sink your teeth into, and Kayla was instrumental in your future success. Guys, don't forget to subscribe, like this video, and tune into the next video. All right, guys? See ya.
Bye.